This is the Charlie Pen, as announced in yesterday's video. There's one little detail for any illustrator, artist, or cartoonist about this particular pen. The existing feed that's in it is designed for a medium fine to fine nib, and it is also designed for Heart of Darkness. Some of you know that Heart of Darkness tends to flow a little more rapidly than Noodler's Black. It tends to dry a bit faster than Noodler's Black. It's the permanent black that is the opposite of anti-feather black. Noodler's anti-feather black is a kind of black that you can write on an airline tissue paper and not expect it to feather much. Whereas Heart of Darkness would feather. However, the rate of penetration is greater, and on many other paper grades, no smearing, yet it's permanent. It's nowhere near as fast as Bernanke Black, which is instantaneous, but it's very fast for a permanent black. And because this feed is designed for such a stingy flow, if you make a 2 millimeter wide or 1.5 millimeter wide italic, and you want to use this for shading or for filling or for other artistic applications, the existing feed is not going to be able to keep up with the ink flow that will be demanded, particularly if you need to use something like anti-feather black or something that you want that intensity, the definition of the line on paper. You don't care about dry time. You simply want it to be as dark as night and with extremely high definition, no feathering whatsoever. You will encounter reduced flow. Here is a this can be obtained. It's a hobby saw. It's a type of hacksaw. A coping saw at Home Depot or Lowe's would work just as well. And what you're looking for is a saw blade that is as wide as the ink channel, preferably one that has teeth that go all the way to the end. Otherwise, you would have to cut off the end. You would need teeth to end here, not down here, because if you have a flat area, what will happen is that you'll have to cut off the end of the feed, and you don't want to do that with a vented nib feed. If you do that, you'll have two air vents. You'll have a vent in the front and a vent in the back, and a double air vent means you'll likely experience drooling. What you want to do for an italic that's 2 millimeters wide to 1.5 millimeter wide is go into, and you could gently put the ebonite in a vise. You go into the air channel and gently remove material. You're looking to only remove about 0.5 millimeter. It doesn't take much. And it can be fairly sloppy. You just want to make sure you're in the center of the air channel. This is relatively sloppy, but you don't have to acid etch it. You don't have to do anything to it. The ebonite, with a soak of maybe upwards of 5 to 10 minutes, especially with this ink, I'm going to aim for, and this is just like in the prior video on making an italic nib, I'm aiming for about 2 millimeters. These are friction fit. It's very easy to remove. They also interchange with the smallest piston filler that Noodlers makes, Nib Creeper. And when you're cutting the air channel deeper, you want to get as far forward as you dare, but at a very minimum, you want that deeper air channel to be at the hole of the nib, the air vent of the nib. If you don't make it, and you only cut it deeper down here, there's no way the air can replace the ink that you need for the added demand. Now, I'm not necessarily going to polish this. There's a technique I didn't mention in the previous video, but you can, as you're cutting, you can gently turn and you'll wind up with a little curved edge. This is in case you maybe you're in a rush. You can also hone it on the steel of the plier, of the wire cutter, instead of removing material. That's basically taking your metal and lowering the mountains into the valleys without removing material. Also, if you lack polishing paper, you will not get a tight edge using that technique, but you will get an italic line. The blade-like edge absolutely requires polishing paper. There it is. That's say that's about a 2 millimeter. For the dramatic, I guess. Made it quite wide. But that's what this is capable of. You could actually get out to 3 millimeter if you made sure that the feed was generous enough. You could make this pen deliver a 3 millimeter line. And see how it does not skip. That channel is huge. You would be able to put all sorts of calligraphy nibs using this feed. It's like a paintbrush. And with a lighter touch, let's see if it writes on an extent. This is always my test to see the advantage of a fountain pen over a rollerball or an ink ball or a marker pen. Is that it can write without pressure. If you notice, I'm holding the paper off of the table and it is still writing, flowing, and making the full line. So it's literally writing without any pressure. There aren't many writing instruments that can do that, but the fountain pen always can. And it's one of the reasons I consider it the ultimate, most adaptable, most versatile, and most utilitarian of all writing instruments. You can't beat it. Anyway, that's the little tutorial on how to make a 2 millimeter broad rounded italic using a this little saw cost me 15 cents at a local big box store, and they sell them at places like Harbor Freight, Home Depot, Lowe's. You can pick them up in the hardware, and it's very easy, it's very affordable, and that pen's probably going to be more numerous. There's been some positive feedback, and it is likely if people like the initial 140, it will become standard with Heart of Darkness. That's all. Hope you learned something.